Alo, mình chơi Zonomani. Zonomani Chapter 1.
Thank you.
Mình sẽ lấy kiến tiếp theo. Thank you.
sớm không? Em gửi cho bác đó thì làm phải giữ đi làm.
one. Here. I wanted to thank you for freeing me. I was stuck in prison for so long. Thank you. I'd like to see you back. There's a train station nearby. It needs a code, and I have it. We're gonna get out of here. As soon as you get on up here... Hey, I'm up here! I see you. I should be able to follow you through the vents. This way. Listen, I'm going to need you to trust me.
Welcome to Musical Memory. This advanced memory and cognitive recognition test is designed to stimulate several segments of the brain, allowing us to see how quickly and efficiently your brain works. A sequence of colors will be shown, and you must recreate the exact sequence using the buttons around you. Bunzo will slowly lower towards you. When you complete a color pattern correctly, Bunzo will rise back up. When you input a pattern incorrectly, Bunzo will lower towards you faster. If Bunzo reaches you, your test is over. The test will become more difficult as it continues, with longer patterns in quicker succession. That's all. Good luck.
Job. Mommy has decided to give you part of the code for the train. Look on. Mummy was hoping the game could last a little longer. It's okay, though. Mummy knows other ways to play with you.
What's the time?
Playtime!
but she needs you. We need you. You are our mission. Together, we can save a lot of people, including you. Lake Erie straight ahead is the home of Catnip, one of the smiling critters. There used to be 8 of them, I think. Now it's just him. Lake Erie is his church.
Around at the world today, what one thing do you think it needs more of? I asked around once. Money, I never have enough. Understanding, I can never get any. Faith, the common man has lost it. Each answer was different, and I could perhaps see some little truth in each, but I think each was also missing something. Something simple. You see, not one of them could muster a smile. A smile is hope. A smile is love. A smile is understanding. And there is nothing more gratifying to my soul than being the reason for a child's smile. To be the spark that ignites all their hopes and dreams. For it is only through hopes and dreams that we may create a better world. One where our children need not be afraid. One where they are protected. After all, this company and its toys are nothing without them. These children deserve to smile. They deserve to love. And they deserve a safe home. That is why it is with enormous pleasure that as the founder of Playtime Co., I announce PlayCare, our very own on-site orphanage. But it's not only that. It's a school, a playhouse, a place to belong. Our very own ecosystem beneath the surface. Dedicated in every inch and detail to ensuring a child's smile. It's teachers and counselors, mothers and fathers, until such a time they have all of that in you. May PlayCare bring joy, inspiration, and smiles to all who enter these doors. For what gives life its meaning if not a smile?
Now the question your problem asking yourself is...
Hi, my name is Blade Pierre, and I'm the head of innovation here at the Playtime Co. Toy Factory. If you're seeing this, then you're trespassing. Yeah, we play this little tape on loop whenever we close the factory for the day. So, trespasser, just to make you aware, while we pride ourselves primarily on our high-quality toys and excellent child care, we also pride ourselves on our security. For example, this facility is full of hidden motion triggers, which, once set off, will turn on the factory's emergency alarms and directly contact the authorities. And that's one of the more tame aspects of our security system. No spoilers. So, you've got my warning. It's not too late to turn around. I just hope that you're certain whatever you're doing is worth it.
Thank you. Stella. What made you want to work at the Playtime Co. Factory?
Playing with toys when I was young was so magical. I could go straight from my bedroom floor to anywhere in the world. It was such a great feeling. And being able to work at a toy factory, somewhere that can provide kids with the same experience, that's a pretty great feeling too. Sometimes though, I really wish I could go back to being a kid. And it's weird, because adults are just kids, but older. I don't think anyone ever really feels like an adult. Your body just gets older, older, and then you die. Human bodies just can't stay young forever. There's things, though. Like some trees that can stay alive even while being way older than a person. I mean, the oldest people to ever live are still younger than those. So I guess everyone is always young relative to something, right?
All right, I think we're getting a little off track. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.